Hey guys, it's TownieSimBuilds here, and welcome back to another build challenge. So as you can clearly tell from the title of today's video, this is not going to be a standard every room challenge, but something a little bit different and something that I don't believe someone has ever tried before. So just kind of exploring YouTube, I was trying to get inspiration for another build challenge, and I had this random idea of building a house using only one expansion pack, but the twist being that I cannot use any base game materials. So going into the lot itself, we are clearly in the world of Mount Cymreby, the world that came with Snowy Escape, and obviously Snowy Escape is going to be our expansion pack today. Overall, I'm going to try and go for a more traditional Japanese-inspired build. It's not going to be 100% authentic, but I will do the best I can with this, and hopefully include a lot of different rooms. So I do believe I want a dining room, a living room, a kitchen, bathroom, a parents' room or master bedroom, a children's room, and then finally a backyard area of some kind. So it's going to be a little bit wild, you guys, but we're going to see if we can do this. We're going to see if this is actually possible. All right, so going in, we're just going to use some of these tools. Some of these tools I'm just going to have to use. I do need to use the wall tool, unfortunately. Just things like this that are just part of base game and are unavoidable. But for anything that is customizable, anything that has other options that are not base game, I do have to use. That is my goal. So I figure I would like something like this. I do have some references pulled up. I can't really guarantee how authentic this is going to be, but I just want to take inspiration. So I'll create something like this with a nice entryway. I'm thinking the front can be a little bit symmetrical, and I don't really mind that too much. I'm thinking there can kind of be a east and west wing, if you guys know what I mean. And I do have my filter already on, so I think this will make it easier. All right, I'm looking at references for paneling. I don't like this solid block here, so I'm gonna try to mimic some of the ones I'm looking at. I think some of these are onsen, some of these are also what look to be residential homes. It's kind of a mixture of different things. But I do like this look so far. Not like we have any choices. Not like we have a lot of choices, but that is okay. That is the name of the build. More of a shoji screen on the inside, just like that. I don't think I want them so dense. So I think I can space them out just a little bit like this. Now, I do think I would like some kind of courtyard area in the middle. I think that could be really cool. But I do want to get most of the base stuff down first. And it looks like we only have one kind of flooring. Unless we would like some sand on the inside, which is very interesting. But it looks like we have tatami mats. So I'm just going to lay them down. I know that there is supposed to be a pattern to how this is done. I'm not very good at it, unfortunately. I'm going to try and look maybe a little later. But if not, I'm just going to use this for now and use this as the flooring option. All right, now for windows, let's see what we have. We can do something larger like this, which is not too bad. We do have some that go down to the floor. All right, gonna try out this option. I do like that it has the shoji screen here, but it does look a little bit more like a traditional window that can kind of slide in and out. So I think this could be interesting. Okay, so there we go. I'm thinking I will make this, what do I do? Okay, I think one can be a living room. One can be a dining room. This is going to be the main entry area. There is usually a sort of central lobby in the house where you would receive guests. So that's going to be the entrance way, just like that. Kitchen should probably extend over this way. I'm not sure how it's going to connect just yet, but I'm thinking it can be somewhere over here. Oh, I forgot we're supposed to do a courtyard. Okay, so the kitchen can go probably here. I would like another area back here. This could potentially be the bathroom. I'm gonna try and mirror it, and it almost makes an H shape, which is a little funky, but probably something like this. And then having a courtyard area in the middle. Let me just lay these down super quickly. I'm gonna make them more or less homogeneous just to make my life easier, but I hope this works out. I hope this works out, you guys. All right, so roofs are going to be a little bit hard, you guys, because the problem is with the roofs. Unfortunately, we do have these. I do believe they're called the eaves of the roofs themselves, roof trims. That's a better word. And there are a lot of base game options, but I'm probably not going to use any. And if I can disable the trims themselves, I'm definitely going to have to do that. So I'm thinking I will use this. I'll use this hipped roof. Trying to match a lot of the styles of the roofs. Snap. That's not correct. I would like for it to come to a point in the middle, but I just don't think we have anything like that. But this is probably going to work the best for now. But obviously, I do have to change out the tiles themselves. So we'll probably go for something like this. Can I extend these out a little bit? Yes, we can. Perfect. Okay, it's very symmetrical. Very symmetrical, but I do like how it's coming along. I do wish the courtyard area was a little bigger, so let me actually see if I can shimmy these over just a little bit. I think one more tile on each side would be great. I kind of would like a connecting area here. I'm not sure how it's going to work. I might just fence it in, but if there was a little outdoor walkway, I think that could be really interesting. I'm thinking I can do maybe a smaller section like this. Going to use this wood paneling once more. And I think for this section, what I'm going to try and do is I want to bring this texture once more, but I'm not going to completely wall it off. I do think I want some kind of archway or open area of some kind. Perhaps we have some columns here, kind of like support beams going across. And like I said, I'm just going to use more of these pillars here. I think this is the only one we have with this pack, unfortunately. You know, a little bit of an open area like this, I think that works fine. Can we get in a little bit of landscaping? Because this lot is very barren. Let's see what we have from Snowy Escape. I will probably also go into debug because we don't really have too many options here. This one feels more, a little bit more like a bonsai tree, which is very beautiful, but it's a little too stylized for what I'm going for. So I think these will work fine like this. I do like some of these plants, so I think we can incorporate something like this just to accent the sides a little bit. Gonna use another cluster and kind of swish it around and recolor it so it looks a little bit different than its twin on the other side. Something like this. Ooh, I love this tree. This tree is really great. I love that it's a little bit more narrow. I can kind of have the branches overhang just a little bit. Ooh, fencing. This fencing looks really cool. We do have an option that is part of the game itself, so I could use either this debug fence piece, or I could use the, I think it's only one option we have in Snowy Escape, but we're going to see how that works. Ah, perfect. Okay, I do like this grass, so let me use some of this. I'm going to try and make the landscaping a little bit more overgrown. I do like some of these plants, so I think we can use stuff like this just to fill in some of the gaps around the trees. A little bit more diversity in the flora around here, so I do think this is looking better. I do think I will take advantage of some of these overhanging options, and if you guys have cottage living, you will know that there is a very similar looking object to this, but I think this is a nice way to cover up some of the empty trims that unfortunately I had to leave out because a lot of the options were base game. And yeah, I honestly don't mind this. I imagine this house could be more so on the countryside, so I think a lot of this could work great. Getting creative with the limitations, you guys, that is the way to go. for better or for worse, this is shaping up. What I could also do is find an awning like this. I think it's just a nice way to complete the look. And we can also mirror the tile on the roof as well. Now, I do also like this other fence piece, and I'm not really sure what it is exactly. But I do like these little bars right here. So I think what we can do is we can actually have them in the window like this, just to give a nice little design accent as well. All right, guys, we do have to settle this fence debate. We do have this option from debug, so that is on the table. But let's see what else we do have. Okay, we have two. We have two options, so it's not too dire. And I think what we can actually do is I think we can use the second option over here just to kind of block this area in a little bit. I'm not going to keep the flooring, obviously, but I think this gives this just a little bit more, a little bit more of a disconnect from the outside of the lot, but just enough to give a little bit of space for the family here. So I do think this works quite well. And I think for the front, what we can actually do is use the debug fence, and we're going to try to use it as a sort of accent piece. Where are you? We're only one pack, and you're still very hard to find. Did I pass it? No, here we go. Perfect. All right, so I'll use this. I think what I'll do is I will block off probably a portion of the front yard a little bit. Okay, I think it's coming together. Do I need anything else here? I think what I would like are some lanterns, because it is going to be pretty dark out here. I do love this option if we do have a more neutral color. Yes, I do like this option a lot. And I will also go into the courtyard area and also add in some lights, because if the family's spending time out here, yeah. We want to see what we're doing here. We want to enjoy nature, but with a little bit of light on the side. Can I put you here? Maybe? Right at the entrance? I'm going to float you off the lot a little bit, so move objects on. I don't really think this lot is going to be available, but maybe if you guys enjoy it enough, I'll put it up. We'll definitely see how things go. I think at this point, I will go back into debug, and I think I want to clutter up the fences a little bit. You know, if we are sticking with more of that overgrown look, I do like having some foliage going along the fence as well. These are actually not bad. Maybe we can do flower beds around it. It might be a little bit too much, but it's not too bad. I also like these lighter blue options here. So I think what I'll do is actually pat them in like this. And it does match some of the ones in the environment, which is always a plus. Oh, snap. Okay, perfect. Okay, I do see more fence pieces using the same idea I had in mind. I tell you guys, I did not see them before. So this works out even better if it looks like it blends into the environment. Now, I will say I wish I had some kind of stepping stones to use. Normally, I do pull directly from the base game debug, but I'm going to look through things here. It doesn't look like we have anything, unfortunately, so we may have to pass on that, but it's okay. I think we can do without it. But other than that, I think we are ready to go on inside. And if for some reason I do have more ideas for the outside, we can always just kind of scooch on back and then see what we can do there. So starting off, we do have the entryway here. I will also use this door once more because we do need a nice entryway towards the main courtyard area. I think we'll start with the dining room area first. Again, our options are very slim, unfortunately. I'm going to use an option that aligns a little bit better with the two main entryway doors. So we could do something like this if we do want a little bit of a look inside, which I don't really mind, especially because, you know, even though this is a household, it's not like a bedroom where you can see into someone's private quarters. So I think this works fine. And then going into the dining room itself, we do have an option to put more windows, so I can use these once more. Ooh, this is actually a pretty nice option. It's not so long and narrow, but it does work like this, and it does give a pretty nice amount of light, I think. And let me see what we have for lighting once more. We did have these really gorgeous lanterns for the outside, but I do think we're in need a little bit of some kind of overhead lighting. All right, I do like these lanterns here. Has a little bit of what I presume to be kanji, or at least the simlish variety of it, so I think that works fine like this. Okay, so for the dining table, we do have some options. We do have this really nice, kind of more standard option that we can use, but we also have a kotatsu table as well, which I think could fit in really nicely. So given that this lot is a little bit more traditional, I do think this kind of seating matches the aesthetic of the house a little bit more. So I think we'll do this. And then for the room itself, let's see what we have in terms of decor. So we do have some possibilities for a scroll here, so I think I'll put one like so. I would like a little bit of plant life in here somehow. I do know that rooms in Japan are usually very minimalistic. There's usually not a lot of clutter, which I really appreciate. I really do enjoy that. So I want to keep it minimalistic. I don't want to put too much in here. Ooh, okay, we do have some shelving units, which are not bad. So we could do something like that. We do have this wall here as well. Thinking we can do maybe a smaller painting here. So I'll go back and use our filter. And I think I will probably use something like this. Something a little bit smaller. And on top of this, I totally forgot what I'm doing. I had an object. I had an object in mind, you guys. And then it just totally went whoop and it's gone somewhere. Okay, yes, flowers. Perfect. Probably something like this. All right, this is not too bad. I do like this little moment here. We do have some kind of opportunity to put something here. I'm just not really quite sure what it could be because, again, I don't want to make this space too crowded. So let's see what we have. Could do a low shelf. And I think if I put some objects on there, I think that's the most I would want to do in this room. Otherwise, we do start getting fairly cluttered, but I do think that'll work. I do want to bring in one more of these lanterns, probably over here. But I do like the vibe here. I do think this is fairly fitting for the dining room space, and I think we're ready to move on to the next room. All right, the kitchen now. The kitchen. I do think I want a nice view outside, so I will use more of these windows. Do we have something that's more open? Okay, yes, perfect. We do have these. So I think this can work great. Gotta figure out where I want the fridge to go. Probably not going to be an opening to the bathroom because that's going to be a little bit odd. But maybe we can go through here and enter the bathroom that way. I think that's the best solution. Alrighty, and I do know that there is a set that works, so we can use these. Again, trying to match some of the tones in here. Scoochie scoochie, just like that. The fridges never sit perfectly. You really have to kind of go in and hold Alt and just kind of close that gap a little tiny bit. And then for the placement of our appliances, I think we can do... could do an island in the middle. It's not too bad. Probably veering so far away from being authentic, but I'm trying, you guys. If you are versed in Japanese culture, or if you are Japanese yourself, I do apologize. Again, this is just me making the best of the situation. I would like to research more about Japanese homes so I could create a very authentic build, but this challenge is gonna have some problems. This challenge is just not gonna allow me to do this. Yeah, I think this sink's gonna have to be there, unfortunately. I could shift this down one more like this, and then probably have a partial piece somewhere over here. So just like this, that should do. And then I'll go ahead and use the snowy escape oven right in this area. I think I'm gonna change up the lighting a little bit. I'm actually going to use the overhead ceiling lights, also from Snowy Escape. And now it floats perfectly above it, so that's perfect. I'm gonna see if I can add in any more details from the pack. And I'm not gonna bother with like these smaller categories, you guys, because there's just so little. There's so little to work with. So I'll just go in straight with debug and see everything we have. Ooh, the teapots. I do know there is a teapot shelving unit, if I can find it. I think I'll put it right along perhaps this wall, like this. Better yet, let me actually take these out. I'm going to make this a little bit of an island. I think it'll just make the space a little bit more dynamic. And again, just going in and matching the wood tones like this. And I think I can bring the plates back over. The question is there anything else I can use? I can keep putting more plates, but I think that can only go so far, if you guys know what I mean. I can put another one here. Could use some soap. Some soap could be nice. Maybe along here. This is supposed to be for the shower. I know this is for an onsen, but maybe we can just have a little bit of soap here. Clean our hands by the sink. I think this is just, again, a nice little clutter object that we do need. All right, yeah, I think this actually works. I do like this, you guys. Again, it's much more minimalistic. But I think it is in line with the style. And again, we just didn't really have too much to work with, but I do think this works fairly well. Definitely gets the job done. Yeah, I think this works pretty well. I do want to keep it off-center from the room a little bit, because we do need a little bit of padding in the corner. So I do think that works fine. And I think up next we will conquer the bathroom area. And yeah. Again, we have no tiles for the bathroom, so we are stuck with tatami, unfortunately. Perhaps we can do something about it. Can we change the color at least? Ah, this poor room. This poor, poor room. Maybe this is not tatami. Maybe it's laminate that looks like tatami. I think that's the story we're going for, and I think that's going to have to do. All right, bathroom. I think we do have everything we need. Do we have a bathtub? We do. Perfect. I do know that we also have the toilet, which is a little bit more modern, but it's fine. I think this house could be retrofitted. It already has a lot of more modern devices or appliances inside. The sink could do possibly a double vanity. Again, that's normally my standard, but I think it'll work because there are going to be four Sims in this household. So I will pull these counters once more. There's going to be no toilet paper, but I think this toilet is technologically advanced. Perhaps a nice bidet can do the trick because, again, we can't use the base game toilet paper holder. So good luck to this family. All right, we're going to pull this sink once more because it is the only option we have. But again, it works, so we're going to roll with it. All right, thankfully, we do have these snowy escape mirrors, which I actually love. They're very contemporary, and I do love the very geometric shapes from them as well. So definitely going to use them here and match the wood tones like so. A lot of people have actually created standing showers using the option from the Snowy Escape pack. So I could do something like this. and oh my gosh. I did not use the right color, you guys. There are black panels mixed in with the brown ones, and I completely did not know. Okay, let me go back and fix this, and I'll be right back. Okay, so all of the wood paneling, I believe, has been resolved, so we can get on with this bathroom and complete the look. Just like I said, I'm gonna use the standing shower here and create a little isolated standing shower moment, if you will. Could I possibly do a screen on this area like this? I think that could be interesting, even though it's probably not very conventional. Yeah, I'm not sure. I could do this and possibly use it like that. I really don't know if anybody's going to use it like this, but it can't hurt. You know, creating interesting fixtures in a house, why not? Is there anything else we can use? Oh, there was this divider. Oh. Snap. Okay, well, that was a little late. Maybe we can try it. Let me see. And I think we'll go with probably the darker swatch like this. All right. Yeah, I think it's coming together. And I think with that said, I think this is pretty much it with the bathroom, and I'm pretty happy with it, actually. All right, we're going to circle back to this little entry point here. And because this is a sort of entry hallway, yeah, I would have liked some kind of clutter on the wall, like some kind of hanging clothes. Yeah, okay, I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to take out this door as much as I don't want to, and I'm going to use the ones on the left and right side. So we can still see through. Let me just bring back the other one as well, because I think these are the only ones we have that can work. I'm going to scale this down a little bit. All right, perfect. And I think I'll just put it right here. I'm going to kind of blend it into the build itself. And it's going to be very discreet, so as soon as your Sims come in, they'll take off their shoes. Like I said, I do think I want to add some little bits of plants on the sides. But yeah, bear with me, you guys. I'll bring this guy out and I'll bring this one out. Sometimes you do have to kind of float things in place. Again, this being the example right here. And I think lastly, what I could also do is add in a snowy escape rug, probably a nice fur rug like this. I don't know if you would normally do this with tatami mats. I'm probably gearing towards no. But just for the sake of just something a little bit different in here, I think this can work fine. And I do like that it is semi-transparent. You can still see some of the tatami beneath it. So I think this pretty much wraps it up for the entryway, the little lobby area, if you will. All right, we're now onto the living room space, and I think I'm going to mirror what I did on the other side. I'm going to pull in these windows once more, a lot of these lanterns as well, so I will probably put them roughly in the same place. All right, I think this is looking fine. I will go in and add the living room set, which is absolutely gorgeous. I love these items. There isn't really too much, but I do love this couch, and I know that the bookcase is also very well designed as well. And I can probably use the two chairs that I also love. I'm going to also go in and add this little ottoman guy here. Not going to keep this really cute variant, but I will try to find something that fits. And we will go in now and find that lovely bookcase with the nice dark wood. And I definitely want more art pieces here. I'm thinking I will go back and pull more of these scrolls and possibly some of the paintings as well. Could go with more of a floral, but I think I like the lighter scrolls, so I think I'll go probably like this. For this room, I do think I would also like another altar, so I'm going to repeat what I did over here. Maybe able to reincorporate this rug again, and we are still left with our very limited supply of plants. It's a problem that plagues us. I think I'll mix it up and probably use this little guy over here and situate it right next to the painting itself. All right, we're going to look for debug now because I really need to see if there's anything else we can fit in here. Sort of clutter object, like I can put another mirror here in this little space. And maybe another plant again. We're running out of stuff, you guys. I could also put a little lantern here, perhaps. All right, I think I'm pretty happy with this. I think we do have everything we need in here for the living room. I could have actually put in a fireplace, but I don't really see a place for it. So what I think I'll actually do is I will use a heating unit. And I think for the heating unit, I'm actually going to bring back heating units in the other rooms as well, just so we stay nice and cozy during the winter time. So I'll probably use this, situate it in the corner like this. Okay, so we're moving on to the bedrooms now, and I do want to distribute this space a little bit better. So we can do an even split between the parents and the children themselves, which is not too bad. I just have to make sure that everything is going to fit in each room. So I think that is what we can do. May try to make this smaller. I'm really not sure. I think the doors will fit in easier if I do it like so. Okay, so we do have beds for the kids, which is great. We do have some single sleeper bed options. Or if we're in real life, it's probably like a twin or a twin XL. The dresser in this game is quite large, I'm going to be honest with you guys, but I can scale it down a little bit. I think this is a pretty good size. Probably use something like this. I'm going to swap this around. I think the Sims can get in more easily like so. Yeah, I think this is still accessible, so that's not bad. So we'll keep the arrangement like this. Do like these blue tones once more, so I will reincorporate these. We do have some objects that I believe are void critters. Some designs that are void critters, kind of like Pokemon. Could do this. It's very boring. It's very boring. Okay, I'm gonna keep a little bit of character. I think this brown is maybe close enough, so I'm gonna try that out. And I will try to bring back some of these windows. So perhaps this one. Also bring in these lanterns like this. What else though? What else do I put in this room? I think that's a little bit problematic. I can't actually do the snowy escape posters, which are not too bad. We do have these larger murals, which actually can also work. Oh, we have these little stickers too. We have some fun stuff. So we could do that. That's actually not too bad. This feels a little bit more kid-friendly now. And then maybe a few more posters. I do know that this object has a lot of good options. But yeah, I don't really mind this too much. I don't really mind this poster too much. Maybe they love to keep track of their favorite places to go out and eat. That could be something. And this could be a mother and son, perhaps, you know? Stretching these items the best I can, you guys. I really am. And we also have these really cute little ottomans that always remind me of Mochi. Oh, I love these little guys. I think these are actually from vending machines, so maybe we can use some of these. And it's floating. Everything is floating, you guys. Oh no. I did not realize that was happening. I did not realize everything was floating. I think this is looking pretty good. I'm trying to think if there's anything else. But more or less, I do think that this room is more or less complete for the kids in the household. All right, we're now on the final room. We are finishing the house with the master bedroom, and this is going to be the room for the parents. And overall, I'm just trying to think of how I want the windows this time, but maybe we can get a nice view outside. So I may try to pull these from the kitchen area, put two higher windows up here. And for some reason, my paneling is a little bit off, so let me bring it back like that. Ready to furnish this, we're going to use one of the two beds, and we do have some nice options here. We do have this one here. And I do believe there is one more with a heavy wooden base. Where are you? Where are you? Oh, that's the only one. I thought there was another two sleeper bed option, like another fuller queen size bed, but I guess that's it. Okay, well, easier for me. Here is the one option. So I'm going to situate it like this. I could have also had the bed this way, which may be a little bit more organic. That way you're not jammed up against the door. And I do want to bring over those little accent tables as well. We're going to use them as nightstands, which they actually are used as nightstands. I don't know why I said that. Scratch that, guys. They're nightstands. The team originally intended for them to be used as nightstands. So please excuse my lack of memory here, but these were great. All right, we're going to use the plants once more, you guys. Here we go. I think it's like the same three plants that are being rotated around everywhere, but you do what you got to do and it's okay. Yeah, I think we can match it with this one. So the plants do pair nicely together with a sort of salmon tone. I think that works great. Could potentially have another area here, maybe another little sitting area. And I'll probably just go with these options. I think that's a little bit better with the room itself. Same thing with the dresser. I'll go a little bit lighter like this. That way it fits in better with the bed. Maybe a heater, another one of these heaters over here. Maybe we can safely put it on the table here. I think that could work. If you want to warm yourself by the heater, which is a little weird, but I think it'll do. And then a smaller art piece probably over here. Probably pull this painting once more. Situate it just above the chair like so. Let me see if there is anything else left we can actually put in here. Was thinking we can pull from maybe this once more. Just having another sort of area for clothing, just so the walls don't feel so barren. So I'll probably use this. So unfortunately, we only have one option for blinds. We do have nori-style curtains, if you will. I just don't think I want to use them like this, but I will use these bamboo blinds instead, just to add a little bit of something else to the room itself. All right, so I think I'm pretty happy with how this came out. I do think we have the inside complete. Other than the weird tatami situation in the bathroom, I think this is looking good. The last thing we need to do is to furnish this nice central courtyard area. On that note, I'm also going to go in and unfortunately probably move this lantern out of the way because we do need an entrance to the bathroom. So this option is actually not too bad. Maybe I'll stick with this one. That way we have the utmost privacy in the bathroom. Now, I did want to create a little bit of a Zen garden inspired look. And I could potentially use some kind of water feature, but again, we're going to stray into base game territory. So I'm trying to keep away from it as much as I can. But we do have that really cool sand option that could do the trick. So I'm going to find it right now. I probably would have liked for this to be more dynamic, but I'll do my best. I'll do my best, you guys. I do wish there was a more native way to enclose this, but what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to return to debug and find some nice foliage just so it feels a little bit more natural with the lot itself, so you don't get a hard cut of sand right in the middle of the courtyard. Okay, so we could use something like this, kind of smaller shrubbery going around it. All right, unfortunately, I think these are going to have to go. I think we're just cutting it very close. All right, we do have our base complete. I will also go in and add just a little bit more foliage just so it's not too similar all around. I may be able to bring back some of the stones, but I think I'll have to keep them fairly small. And they don't really go with the circles of the sand, unfortunately, but I do think they'll still look nice nonetheless. So I will put some of these in here. And then I can probably do a little bit of bamboo around the edges. There is the base game option, but again, base game is off the table. But I do believe we did have some options in debug, so let me find those really quickly. Whoa, these are big. Okay, scale them down. I do like a little bit of elevation, so I don't mind them being a little bit larger, so they kind of poke through just a little bit. But yeah, this should be more than accessible for them. Probably going to move that trash can because it's a little weird sitting in the corner there. Not that it's terrible. It's not really a bad position. But it is supposed to be a relaxing area, so maybe I'll just put this on the side of the house somewhere. But I would like to put some chairs over here and possibly use a rug as well. So I'm going to pull this guy once more and probably match with the brown inside. Possibly some plants again if I pull this set right here. I really did enjoy that little fountain that also came with the Snowy Escape pack. So let me see if I can find it. Probably these chairs here. I think these are probably the best option. So they do look quite nice, even though we did use them on the inside. But I do think they work outside quite well. And I'll probably go in and also use this one as well, just to complete this set. That way the whole family can be here, which I think works great. Oh no, you guys, the edges are showing. The edges are showing. All right. We're very close. We're very close to being complete, but let me just move these in a little bit. Ooh, we do need a mailbox. We do need a mailbox. I think that is the final component. And there should be one available in Snowy Escape, so I think we'll be fine there. Yep, here it is. And I'll just stick it probably along the wall like so. So I think this will be our final detail. All right, guys, so we are officially done with the build itself. This is the one expansion only featuring Snowy Escape with absolutely no base game. Everything you see is directly from the Snowy Escape catalog and or from the debug catalog, also from Snowy Escape. I know for me that this was a really fun challenge, and this was probably one of the larger houses that I've done while doing a live build challenge like this one. With that said, I hope this also inspired more build challenges of your own, and I'll definitely see you guys in the next build challenge as well. With that said, this has been TownieSimBuilds signing off. Thank you so much for watching, guys.